It's only a story, Jack. Giants aren't real.
Hello and welcome to Every Screen. Today we are going to recap a fantasy action movie titled Jack the Giant Slayer. The movie begins with a young Jack. In the enchanting kingdom of Cloister, a timeless tale unfolds, weaving together the threads of adventure, romance, and mythical wonder. Our protagonist, Jack, a young farm boy with dreams as vast as the kingdom itself, is captivated by the legend of Erik, an ancient king who wielded a magical crown to vanquish an army of invading giants from a realm in the sky. As the legend echoes through the years, Princess Isabel becomes ensnared by the same mythical lore that has captured Jack's imagination. The stage is set for a narrative that transcends the boundaries of time, seamlessly intertwining the destinies of two souls drawn together by the echoes of an epic past. A decade later, we find Jack on the cusp of a transformative journey. His rustic life takes a turn as he ventures into town, seeking to sell his horse to support his uncle's farm. Little does he know that this seemingly ordinary day will become the prelude to an extraordinary saga. In the bustling town, Jack's gaze locks onto Isabel, and the spark of infatuation ignites within him. Jack's chivalrous spirit emerges as he defends Isabel's honor from a band of thugs, casting himself as a modern-day hero in a kingdom beset by mythical shadows. Meanwhile, Lord Roderick's return to his study is marred by the discovery of a theft, setting off a chain of events that will entangle him in the web of giants, magic, and destiny. The narrative takes a dramatic turn as a monk, cloaked in shadows, offers Jack an otherworldly proposition, a handful of magic beans stolen from the treacherous Lord Roderick. These beans, seemingly insignificant, become the catalyst for a fantastical journey that transcends the boundaries of reality. Back at the castle, Isabel's struggle for freedom unfolds. A quarrel with her father, King Bramwell, sets the stage for a clash between duty and desire. Jack's own household mirrors this conflict as his uncle scolds him for what seems like foolishness, throwing the beans on the floor in disdain. The night takes an enchanting twist as Isabel, driven by a longing for exploration, sneaks out of the castle. Seeking refuge from the rain, she finds herself in Jack's humble abode, a shelter that becomes the epicenter of a magical storm. The beans, planted in the fertile ground of destiny, sprout into a colossal beanstalk, carrying the house and Isabel into the sky as Jack plummets to the ground below. The ascent up this otherworldly beanstalk becomes a symbolic journey into the realms of legend and lore. Jack, Roderick, and the loyal attendant Wick volunteer to join the King's Knights, led by the valiant Elmont and his second-in-command, Craw. This ascent, fraught with treacherous intent, unveils the giant's realm, a celestial canvas painted with the hues of danger and destiny. Betrayal simmers as Roderick and Wick, cutting the safety rope, intentionally sacrifice knights in pursuit of their hidden agenda. At the apex of the beanstalk, the revelation of the giant's realm forces the group to split into two factions, one led by Jack, Elmont, and Craw, and the other by the duplicitous Roderick and Wick. A dance with destiny awaits as Jack's group encounters a giant, leading to a harrowing confrontation. Jack's bravery and quick thinking spare him from captivity, setting the stage for an unforeseen alliance with the giant's betrayed princess, Fee. This twist adds a layer of complexity to the narrative, blurring the lines between friend and foe. As the plot thickens, Jack's journey becomes a race against time and treachery. In the giant's stronghold, the tragic demise of Craw unfolds, setting the tone for a confrontation with the two-headed giant leader, Fallon. Isabel and Elmont, imprisoned in this celestial fortress, become pawns in a cosmic chess game. Roderick's dark agenda takes center stage as he wields the magic crown, enslaving the giants and plotting an invasion of Cloister. The impending doom casts a shadow over the fate of Isabel and Elmont, their lives hanging in the balance. Jack's intervention becomes a pivotal moment as he rescues the captives and faces the moral quandary of wielding the beans that could alter the course of destiny. The descent from the giant's realm becomes a breathtaking race against time. The giants, using Roderick's stolen beans, create beanstalks to descend upon Cloister, setting the stage for a climactic showdown. Jack, Isabel, and the kingdom's inhabitants brace themselves for an otherworldly siege. The final act unfolds within the castle's walls, transformed into a battleground. Elmont's strategic brilliance fills the moat with oil, igniting a fiery barrier against the giants. Fallon, relentless in his pursuit, breaches the castle from below, initiating a siege that will test the mettle of heroes and the resilience of a kingdom. Fallon's capture of Jack and Isabel becomes the backdrop for the grand finale, a moment of revelation and reckoning. Jack, faced with the enormity of the threat, hurls the final bean into Fallon's maw, triggering a cataclysmic rupture that rips the beanstalk apart. The giants, expelled to their celestial realm, mark the triumph of mortals over myth. In the aftermath, Jack and Isabel emerge victorious, their love transcending the boundaries of legend and reality. The tale echoes through generations as they marry, sharing the story of giants with their children. The magic crown, now a relic of the extraordinary, is enshrined as St. Edward's crown in the Tower of London, a testament to a saga that defied the limits of imagination. As the credits roll, the audience is left with a lingering sense of wonder. Jack the Giant Slayer becomes more than a cinematic journey. It is a testament to the timeless power of myth, the resilience of the human spirit, and the enduring magic woven into the fabric of fantastical tales.